Hello students, welcome to MJC Learning. Today we are going to study chapter 3 of your subject bookkeeping and accountancy, that is admission of partner. So let's begin. Today we will be dealing with question number 9, which is on page number 166 of your government textbook. I'll read out the question. Mr. Amit and Baban share profit and losses in the ratio 2:3 respectively. Their balance sheet as on 31st March 2018 was as under. When we have a look on liability side, we have creditors and capital balance of old partners. On asset side, we have cash, land and building, plant, furniture, stock, debtors. They decided to admit Kamal on 1st April 2018 on the following terms. Kamal shall have 1/4 share in the future profit. She shall bring 50,000 as her capital and 40,000 as her share of goodwill. Land and building to be valued at 60,000 and furniture to be depreciated by 10%. Provision for bad and doubtful debts is to be maintained at 5% on sundry debtors. Stock is to be valued at 1,10,000. The capital account of all partners to be adjusted in their new profit and loss ratio and excess amount be transferred to their loan account. And we need to prepare profit and loss adjustment account, capital account and new balance sheet. On reading the question, we come to know there is adjustment relating to land and building, debtors and stock. And for that reason, I have done star mark over here. So let's start posting, starting with liability side. First is creditors. There is no adjustment. So directly creditors will go in new balance sheet, outer column. So I have posted creditors. Next, capital balance of Amit and Baban, that is 1 lakh. It will become opening balance in partner's capital account. So by balance brought down for Amit 1 lakh, Baban 1 lakh. Now on asset side, for cash we will be preparing working note. Next is land and building 50,000. Next, plant 60,000. There is no adjustment related to plant, so directly we can post it in the outer column. Next, furniture 4,000. After that, stock 1 lakh. And lastly, debtors 16,000. Additional information. They decided to admit Kamal. So Kamal is new partner and he shall be having one-fourth share in future profit. Next, he shall bring 50,000 as his capital. So what is the journal entry for capital? Yes, it is cash account debit to incoming partner account. So that is why we have prepared cash account where the opening balance is 1,10,000, which I have written over here, and to Kamal's capital account. Kamal is bringing 50,000 as his capital. And second effect would be in partner's capital account. $50,000 in Kamal's column by cash. Moving ahead. And 40,000 as his share of goodwill. Now Kamal is bringing 40,000 as goodwill. So the journal entry for that would be cash account debited to goodwill account, because we are under premium method where the partner is bringing his goodwill in cash. So let us give the first effect, cash account debit to goodwill account. Amount is 40,000. Next effect would be in the goodwill account by cash. That is 40,000. Now, second part under premium method would be that goodwill will now be transferred to the old partners in their sacrifice ratio. And for that, we need to calculate sacrifice ratio of old partners. Now, partners' old ratio is 2:3. So, let us calculate sacrifice ratio. Now, in order to calculate sacrifice ratio, we first need to calculate new ratio. So, we'll start with the formula. Balance of 1 would be 1 minus balance of new partner share. Kamal's share is 1/4. 1 minus 1/4, 4 ones are 4 minus 1, that would be 3/4. So new profit sharing ratio would be, their old ratio is 2/3 multiplied by balance of 1 from step number 1, that is 3/4. 3 twos are 6, 5 fours are 20, 3 threes are 9, 4 fives are 20. Kamal's share is 1/4. In order to equalize the denominators, 4 5s are 20, and that is why in numerator and denominator we will be dividing by 5. 5 1s are 5, 5 4s are 20. Now that all the denominators are same, we can compare the numerators. So the new profit sharing ratio would be 6:9:5. Now that we are having old ratio and new ratio, we can calculate sacrifice ratio. The formula of sacrifice ratio is old ratio minus new ratio. And if you all remember, sacrifice ratio is always calculated for old partners because they are the one who are making sacrifice. So their old ratio was 2:3, which I have written, minus new ratio. New ratio of Amit is 6/20. And new ratio of Baban is 9/20. So let us solve it. Now the denominators are not same. Here you are having 5 in the denominator and here you are having 20 in the denominator. There is relation between 5 and 20. 5 fours are 20. So in order to equalize the denominators, I will multiply numerator and denominator by 4. So I will get 4 twos are 8. 5 fours are 20. Minus 6/20. Now you can see denominators are same. So directly I can subtract the numerator. 8 minus 6, it gives me 2/20. Similarly for Baban, 3/5 minus 9/20. In order to equalize the denominators, we'll multiply numerator and denominator by 4. So we'll get 4 threes are 12, 5 fours are 20. Now that the denominators are same, I can subtract the numerator. 12 minus 9 gives me 3/20. So the sacrifice ratio will be 2:3. Now let us divide goodwill in the sacrifice ratio. Amount of goodwill is 40,000. Sacrifice ratio is 2:3. 3 plus 2 is 5. So total part is 5. On dividing 40,000 by 5, we get 8,000 into 2. That is for Amit. And 3. That is for Baban. So 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24. So that will get 16,000 and 24,000. So now let us give the effect. The journal entry being goodwill account debit to old partners capital account. That is to Amit account. Next effect would be in partner's capital account by goodwill for Amit 16,000, for Baban 24,000. Further, land and building is to be valued at 60,000. So the new value of land and building is 60,000. Old balance sheet, the value of land and building was 50,000. So clearly there is an increase in the value of land and building. There is an appreciation of 10,000. So second effect would be in profit and loss adjustment account. Since the value of asset is increasing, the journal entry would be land and building account debit to profit and loss adjustment account. And the increase amount is 10,000. Next, and furniture to be depreciated by 10%. Amount of furniture is 4,000. So depreciation of furniture at 10%, we will get depreciation amount as 400. And since the value of asset is reducing, the journal entry would be profit and loss adjustment account debit to furniture account, depreciation amount being 400. Second effect, we will deduct 400 from furniture. So on subtracting 400 from 4000, my final amount in the outer column would be 3600. Further, it is given provision for bad and doubtful debts is to be maintained at 5% on sundry debtors. Debtors amount is 16,000. And on 16,000, we are supposed to calculate 5%. So 16,000, when we remove 5%, we get 800 as RDD. Now RDD increases the liability, so journal entry would be profit and loss adjustment account debit to RDD. And the amount of RDD which we have calculated is 800. Second effect, we will deduct RDD from debtors. Final amount would be 15,200. Next, stock to be valued at 1,10,000. So the new amount of stock is, in old balance sheet the amount of stock was 1 lakh, now it is increased to 1,10,000. So clearly there is appreciation or increase in the value of stock by 10,000. Since the value of asset is increasing, the journal entry would be stock account debit to profit and loss adjustment account, and increase value is 10,000. Now all the adjustments are done, only the final adjustment is remaining, that we will be doing after closing profit and loss adjustment account. So let us close our cash account on adding 1,10,000, 50,000 and 40,000. It totals to 2 lakhs. So the closing balance of cash account would be 2 lakhs. And as you can see, both the sides goodwill account is tallied. Now let us close profit and loss adjustment account. Credit side is more, so 10,000 plus 10,000, that gives us 20,000. And on subtracting 1,200, that is 800 plus 400, the balance would be 18,800. Now this 18,800 we need to divide in old partners, that is Amit and Baban, in their old ratio, and the old ratio is 2:3. Clearly there is profit as credit balance is more. So 18,800 old ratio is 2:3, 3 plus 2 is 5. On dividing by 5, we get 3,760 into 2 is the share of Amit, we'll get 7,520, and multiplied by 3 for Baban, we will get 11,280. So let us transfer the amount. Now the second effect of this would be, or the partner's capital account will be transferred to their respective accounts by profit and loss adjustment account. For Amit it is 7,520 and for Baban it is 11,280. That is the profit they have incurred. Now we'll come to the final adjustment. The capital account of all the partners to be adjusted in the new profit sharing ratio, and the excess amount to be transferred to their loan account. That is, in current problem we have to transfer the excess money by creating partners loan account. So let us calculate the total capital of the firm. The formula is reciprocal of Kamal's profit sharing ratio, that is 1/4, so reverse would be 4, multiplied by his capital, and Kamal's capital is 50,000. When we multiply 50,000 by 4, we'll get the total capital of the firm as 2 lakhs. And now this 2 lakhs we have to divide in new profit sharing ratio. We had already calculated new profit sharing ratio earlier. So the new profit sharing ratio I have mentioned over here, and we are multiplying the total profit of the firm for each of the partners. So on multiplying, the amount we get for Amit is 60,000, for Baban 90,000, and for Kamal 50,000. So let us do their posting. To balance carried down, 60,000 for Amit, 90,000 for Baban, and 50,000 for Kamal. Now we can close partner's capital account, and whatever will be the excess amount, that will be transferred to the loan account. Kamal accounts get tallied. Now when we have a look at Baban's account, clearly credit side is more. So on adding the credit side, we get 1,35,280. And from that, when we subtract 90,000, the amount which will be transferred to loan account would be 45,280. Now let us calculate for Amit. On adding credit side, it totals to 1,23,520. And from that, when we deduct 60,000, the loan amount would be 2nd effect of the loan account would be transferred to balance sheet. So let me make the changes over here. For Amit, it is 63,520. For Baban, 45,280. Now finally, the closing balance will be transferred to the balance sheet. Amit is 60,000. Baban is 90,000. And Kamal is 50,000. On adding, we'll get it as 2 lakhs. And on adding loan from partner, their total is 1,08,800. To that, when we add 1,40,000 and 2 lakhs, the total of liability side would be 4,48,800. And when we add all the assets side, the total which we get is 4,48,800. As you can see, both the side the amount is same, that is our balance sheet is tallied. Hope you all have understood today's problem. See you.